Okay, we're gonna start it up. Got all four plugs changed for my backup used plugs, my XLs. We'll see what they do. They help. If it runs okay, rev it up a little bit and see if it see if it'll run okay. And if that noise is still there. Okay. Why is it worse instead of better? I got it. The only reason I had it running at all is because I had the, now the sun's getting out where I sit. Right now, let's see. Only reason I kept it running at all is I opened up that vacuum line I have that goes to the intake, the bottom of the carburetor. Right above the intake manifold, and I was spraying starter fluid. I was spraying carburetor cleaner in there because I thought that might clean something out. I did yesterday or whenever it was when it gave me trouble with the starter fluid. And that is how I got it, you know, to run a little. Oh, I didn't have my oval gloves on, so it's all over my hands. It probably, somebody should go wash them, I guess. And I forgot how to get in here. Yeah, the front end is getting hot. Sun is, I didn't think it was going to happen this soon. It's hitting exactly. And under the hood, I'm out of the sun, but it's hitting exactly right where I've got to crawl in. It's only the first 4 or 6 inches right now, but it's going to, maybe when the sun moves a little more, it'll get better. But, I'm going to take my light and look at the recording. I'm about to need my gloves to keep from burning my hands when I try to move around and touch this front of this truck. Okay. It acts like it's not getting fuel. Now. Maybe that fuel is bad. Wait. No, it's got fuel in it. It's full and it looks clean. Let's take the thing off of it. Air cleaner. Let's see what's going on there. Shouldn't be unforeseen or something that's been setting this long. I kind of squirted around. I did that, but I think I did it with starter fluid. Didn't realize I had carburetor cleaner in there in my truck behind the seat. I had a fairly new can and starter fluid and had a little bunch of all the normal stuff that you. I always kept all that kind of stuff in the truck so that if I had any trouble, I could fix it on the road, you know, at least get it going again. But that fuel filter is clean. No, I don't see that any tap on it. I don't see anything coming up. Not a thing. Ow. Let's see. I'm trying to see what's in my picture. Oh yeah, you can see the carburetor. I don't know how good the picture is. I can't tell that by the screen, but it's probably okay. There's nothing in there. I used to have a starter switch. I don't know if it would work on this or not. I mean, I didn't. I'm trying to remember. I used to use it on my 64 Chevelle. It came with a 6-cylinder, but I had somebody put a 350 in it back when I was in the 74 when I was a teenager. It was my second car. I wrecked my first car. 1960, 61, 62 Buick Invicta with a 445 Wildcat. Big block. Burned oil, fell the plugs ever so often in a couple, two, three of them, but it would run 110 all day long. Just a smooth cruiser. And then I got my 64 Chevelle, and it had air conditioning and everything, but it had a 6-banger. I didn't like that. Anyway, that, and I think my 64 panel truck, I put a 454 and a turbo 400 in it. That, I think I might have used that starter switch. But this, I don't know if it's... you hooked it up on the starter, and then you could just mash the button and start it. I think as long as the key was turned on. I don't know if you can do that in... I kind of don't see why you couldn't, if I knew where it was. I have an idea where it could be, but I have to do some digging to find the box that it might be in. You know, none of the screws have been changed or anything. It shouldn't... Well, it was running real good. I mean, I put the new... fuel transfer turbine there, and it was running great. The only thing it did is it would kind of bog if you tried to rev it up when it was cold, and I never did really warm it up. I didn't expect to have any trouble. But, Now it's doing what it did yesterday. Doesn't want to run it on. So the plugs didn't help, and I don't think I just put in four bad plugs, you know. Even if I had one or even two bad plugs, it should run and not just die. If you try to rev it up even the tiniest little bit, it just kills it. So, yeah, no fuel. You let it try to idle, it just sits there running rough and then dies. Could have bad spark, plug wires, or I could have something. I could still have valve problems, because that's what it sounded to me like. You know, what did have it up and running? The valve troubles. Sounded with the tailpipe most of all, is where I got the clue on that. But, yeah, I would like to be right here and start it, and you know, you can always give it gas from there or on the other side. I'm always, it's a little harder to stay away from the fan and the alternator and everything on this side. I like, and plus you can reach the carburetor better. You don't have to lean over and get your face in front of it in case it backfires or something. So usually I get on that side and do that, but if I want to try to do that or what, I don't see any point in changing all those plugs on that side until I figure, I think, and I could check, you know, checking my plug wires is not a bad idea, I don't believe, but it's starting for fuel. I realize that now. It didn't, it could be that the darn old, well, it does have a I just said it didn't have a transmission cooler. It does have one, and it's built into the radiator. I was looking up. I thought that was a fuel line for a minute. I was like, no,
that goes to the radiator.
It's a metal line, you know, going up to a rubber hose. But the fuel pump, it's not leaking or anything, but that don't mean it didn't go bad. Could be why it's not revving up right. Got fuel right now. I mean, you couldn't tell whether it was, you know, when I'm up in the cab, I can't see my filter. To see if it's, I guess if I reviewed my videos, I might be able to tell. I was kind of wanting to do that this morning to listen to that sound, but I didn't have time. I didn't come out for that. So, that's my missing ground has got something to do with it.